And gentlemen, it's finally that time. Welcome to Tennessee Turmoil. My name is Captain Law, and sadly, I'm joined on commentary not by my own choice, but by the idiot who booked this entire shit show, by current UWA World Heavyweight Champion Jake Howell.
And you know, I'm happy to be here. I am now social distancing because I don't have COVID. I just want to get away from you. But for one night, I'll be partial. And this is for Nova.
Indeed.
This is for Nova.
Indeed, it's for Nova as we get started with this wild card battle royal.
We will agree to disagree.
In the yard champion.
Yeah.
He hails from South Dakota.
We're going to get started with this wild card battle royal with the current best in the yard champion. Kurt fucking Adams.
I'll be waiting for tomorrow.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You do face
I do.
Hey, you know who I face tomorrow?
Tristan
Taylor.
All right, cut my music. I really don't need to hear it right now. I want to say a couple things right as the show is about to start. Right about as the show is about to get right underway. About a couple years ago, I traveled from my hometown of Pierce, South Dakota, to where I've never been before. I was claimed the invader of Indiana on a show called Invading Indiana to win this championship. And I'm very proud to hold it over my shoulder. But tonight, on this night, I get to defend this championship against the winner of a tournament. I mean, how often do you get to hear of tournaments, really? But to start it all off, we get a battle royal, and I want to see who my opponents are going to be. So let's get this thing started. Hot and heavy. Let's go.
Well, you heard the man.
Hot and heavy, lovely way to get started, I guess. I mean, it'd be a lot better if I was here with Jonathan Squimbus on commentary, not you. But,
with all due respect, you have good skills talking. I do too. We can look pretty good. We're gonna put everything behind us for one time.
We'll see how this goes.
Now, who is this?
Well, this is a man that has annoyed me on commentary himself multiple times.
Really?
Over on Skullbuster Wrestling. He's not a commentator, he's a former world champion, but he always found a way to interrupt me on the booth. This, ladies and gentlemen, is Mike Everlast Bay.
Is he from Ireland?
He is from Dublin, Ireland.
Dublin, Ireland.
Hence the rocky road to Dublin.
You know, you have to appreciate the international feel of the best in the yard tournament. Anybody can enter.
Indeed, especially this wild card battle royal. You gotta wonder who walked out as the wild card. What mystery surprises will be in store for
yeah
this Royal Rumble style
good gesture there. I don't know really what to say to that.
I mean, the crowd is not behind Mr. Bay today. He might
not
have
at
been,
all.
He might have been doing that towards Kurt Adams.
Now what?
Former experienced tag partner.
Now what's going...
Ah.
I know this man very well.
As do I.
I'd be... Tough competitor.
Anything you could do, I could do both.
Tough competitor.
He can be. He can be. But, I squashed him, so...
For everything said about Dark Story, he's one of the heaviest hitters that I've ever been in the ring with. He does bring the power, and he does bring the pain. He can be a force to reckon with in this battle role as he was in Tennessee Jamboree.
Indeed he could be. You know, Bay is a lot smaller than Dark Skull, but...
It's not the size of the dog in the fight. It's the size of the fight in the dog.
I don't think he's letting that affect him. And the bell's rung. These first two entrants are underway. We are doing this apparently Rumble style.
This should be interesting.
Oh. He's mocking the eagle.
He's mocking the... Oh my God.
He was started off mocking Dark Skull and started mocking the eagle.
Well, Dark Skull didn't like that too much. He just mumbled with a series of kicks and then a big forearm to the back. I was just kicking the shit out of him gang style.
Just on the principle of it, I cannot remember Mike Everlast Bay in this.
I don't know Mike Everlast Bay, but I can tell he has some good fighting spirit. I mean, you can't really see it right now because he's just getting pummeled by this big skeleton man. But
Dark Skull smashing Bay's skull into the canvas.
Yeah, he's a lot of skulls going.
He's Dark Skull implementing those
knees.
Oh
my God, that was a good DDT.
Indeed it was. I don't think I've ever seen Dark Skull implement the knee strikes like that before.
It should be called, I was going to make a damn right now, but as Mike Everlast Bay now has Dark Skull in the corner. Those are some vicious chops.
And I...
Oh!
Double knee strike there in the corner, Tranquilo style.
What do they call that, a meteor? Bay. Oh my God.
Spiked his head.
You and I both could say that nobody likes to be caught on the wrong side of a DDT.
Not at all.
One of the most dangerous maneuvers in wrestling.
You know what's another dangerous maneuver in wrestling?
Wait, whoa. Darcy might be getting over the top rope. No.
You know what's another dangerous move in wrestling?
What's that?
Natural selection.
That is true. Right? Fuck you for a second. We're not going to talk about that right now.
Bay. Spider monkey in the ropes.
This man is Tobey Maguire-ing the ropes. Both beating them up and hanging them on it at the same time. Dark Skull. Is he out? Did he get out?
No, he didn't go over the top rope. The ring announcer is being a bit of a dumbass.
I would say so. High pressure event, but still.
And I agree with the crowd. What the fuck, Bay, calling the announcer out for is that he didn't go over the top rope.
I believe he went through the middle.
He did. He got spider monkeyed in the middle, rope fell to the canvas, and then got basement dropkick.
I think when Darkstar was pounding his head against the canvas and knocked him a little bit silly, and he didn't know like where he was, so he was like spider monkeying on the ropes.
And now the Bay was laying those kicks in with those Tims. Looks like a pair of Tims, maybe a pair of steel toe work boots.
If there are any shoes good enough for stomping people's heads in, they are Timbers.
Indeed. I can actually agree with you on that one. Oh, looks like it's time for the next entrance.
Oh, it's time. Who's it going to be?
I got to go, Jake.
What? Where the hell are you going?
I'll be right back.
What? Okay. I don't like this Titan Tron. This Titan Tron's bullshit, first of all. But, okay. It's weird. He was sitting at the desk. In his Midwest Mafia, I thought he was doing a comp me, but no, he's right here. He's okay. He catch Kurt out of his belt. It's pretty strange. But here comes Captain Law. I'm not going to say many nice things about him. He literally gave me a mild concussion. But I will say, guy's powerful, big powerhouse. Now Captain Law and he looks similar to Riley Bates, but they are not the same person. It's Captain Law with a big kick to Mike Everlast Bay. Look how fucked up I am in the head sometimes as I get people confused. As Captain Law. This crowd is not happy. And rightfully so. This guy can be a dick.
Oh!
Everlast. That was quite the powerful kick. Look into the bollocks, as he was called. Now Dark Skull, Mike Everlast, hey, gonna team up. Big splash. What a Skeletor looking man. So now Dark Skull keeps going as Mike Everlast Bay. It's pretty style, but Dark Skull then fell to his ass. Be looking up for the super thick. I felt that move multiple times. I don't like it very much, and Dark Skull won't like it either. Damn. He caught him with that one. There's no lie. He just caught him straight up. As Mike Everlast Bay looks on like a civilian in Gotham City. As now, oh, wait, Captain Law can be all over the property. He's keeping his feet up. Oh, and he's out. Nothing lasts too long. Wait, Dark Skull got Bay out. That was cheap. Well, you know what?
Everybody's got
for everything. Oh my God!
Everybody's got a bling pick.
Interrupting J.C. Lee. Who's always here to see this? J.C. Lee. PWX. Now he's gonna kick his way down. Apparently, Jesus is also free. This is news to me. Now, J.C. Lee. If it is J.C. Lee, this could be some kind of taunt. I respect somebody for believing in what he believes in. He really wears his heart on his sleeve. And there's J.C. Lee. PWF is now in the house. Now, folks, this is quite the matchup here. We have Dark Skull and J.C. Lee. This is like a crack pipe matchup. There's like, you see this J.C. Lee? Super kick to Dark Skull. Lee. This time, he's like a cheetah with thoughts of an assassin. I don't know when Law's gonna get back.
Damn it.
I see him right there. He's a bit pissed off by all of this. J.C. Lee! J.C. Lee just single-handedly got out Dark Skull. I don't know if it was the power of Jesus or the power of the perks, but this man is on a roll. Now we're counting down.
3, 2, 1.
Who's it gonna be? Who could it be?
Come on, man.
I don't know if I know this particular song. Wait a minute. Mysterious Man. Mysterioso Man. Pink Peck. Mysterioso. Mysterioso. Whatever you want to call him, he's mysterious. This is a very strange song to come out. He's going to cut somebody open. I don't even know what this man looks like. It's all just hearsay. Hold. Okay.
Oh,
there he is. Hell, the UAW.
No.
There is the Mysterioso Man. What the hell?
Hey,
you know what? When he gets back to the commentary table, I'm gonna
talk to him. What the hell?
It's kind of stupid. Now, okay. Now Law and Adams are gonna get face to face here. Come to blow him many times. With one finger. One finger. I mean, that I mean, he might be making
here,
his way back to the.
Not again,
okay, the rest of, that's just completely just disrespectful. I mean, there's still a match going on in the ring. This gives J.C. Lee a hell of an advantage. He's given all this time to rest. While this, quite frankly, this whole shit is going on. 3, 2 Okay, are you back? You back?
Yeah, yeah.
What the hell was that?
Nah, last time we saw Mysterioso, man. Wait! Also, fuck this guy.
Wait!
Fuck Sammy Slay.
Sammy Slay!
Cheap to beat me for the PWF title.
Okay, that's neither here or there. This is... I guess we're going to have a PWF showdown.
But neither here nor there. You were asking about Mysterioso, man. Last time Mysterioso Man made an appearance, it was Nyko Vibe under the mask, and he tried to be the first ever UAW World Heavyweight Champion, and I still beat him. I'm not letting that happen again. Wear a mask. No. It's my cousin, you dumbass.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
But now, Lee, oh my god. Lee's just going straight for Slade.
I... You know what? I'm going for J.C. Lee in this.
J.C. Lee is just pumped, but Slade keeps fucking around and finding out. Senton.
Fuck, Mike Everlast Bay hurts.
I bet. He walloped you.
Dipshit threw me out.
Now he's got to go back to Dublin. Oh, no. Slade. Oh, my God.
Jesus Christ. He couldn't get me up to do that, you know? I mean, he got me up for a TKO.
It's like a freight train coming down from the top of you.
Is he going to throw him out after that?
Is he going to throw him out?
I think JC's got to be dead after that.
No, he's not. He's going to torture him a little bit. After a move like that, doesn't matter what you do. Oh, my God! Wow. You know what? I think I got to go with Sammy Slade.
Even if Jesus is king, I think he's raising hell right now in that ring.
You got hell and heaven in the same ring right now. If J.C. Lee represents heaven, Sammy Slade is hell coming right at you.
Yeah, I've felt
one,
the other
two,
end of J.C.
Three,
of,
four,
Sammy
five,
Slade.
6, 7, 8, 9.
I feel kind of bad for J.C. Lee here.
10. Whoa, my God. Wow.
Jesus. Last time he did that to me, he hit me with a middle rope cutter afterwards.
What?
Yeah.
Well, I guess I gotta go see that. That sounds really satisfying to see. As now Sammy Slade is now in complete control of J.C. Lee.
Indeed, he's climbing up to that second rope. High risk, high reward.
What's he gonna do? Oh!
Attaboy, J.C., attaboy.
J.C. Lee had enough common sense to move, but Slade just ate all of the canvas. Oh, God, he's curb stomping in the head almost.
And not
the wrestling move, just like a straight up curb stomp gang style. J.C. Lee!
What an electrifying move.
That was a very electrifying move.
Shades of El Luchador Gordo with the Candy Rock Bottom, and Slade just
flips him off.
Sends him over.
Slade doesn't go down without a fight, that's for sure. Whether both of these men win or both these men lose, it don't matter. They're making a strong impression on me right now.
JC has a very unorthodox style.
He's...
Jesus Christ!
I compared JC Lee earlier to a cheetah with the thought of an assassin. A very quick, but... Whoa!
God, this
guy. One of the toughest men to ever step foot in this arena.
Is he actually gonna time his entrance?
One can only hope. With King Savage, you get either a full basket of eggs or you like half a carton, but you still get a good wrestler.
Is he gonna get flanked by Dalton though?
I mean, Dalton should be preparing for the tournament.
Because that man can't go anywhere without Dalton Skull by his side.
Friendship is friendship.
No, I call it puppy dog. Ah, there he is.
Dude, that's the lead singer from Ghoul.
He looks like a Ghoul.
Oh my God, J.C. Lee just got sent in the corner. It's now King Savage just straight up walloping on J.C. Lee.
Slade and Savage gonna work together on JC?
Savage. Oh no! No! That was.
Well, just send him to the pearly gates.
Well, We about to see something that... Oh, wait. Well, Kurt Adams and Dalton Schuller. The confrontation, that could... By the end of this night, that could be the result. As now these two men tie up.
Indeed, you're right, it could.
Savage. Savage is straight up. He's no nonsense. He is a kind of a shoot fighter type wrestler. As he just flings himself, Smash Brothers Luigi style, onto Sammy Slade.
Why is Dalton throwing in weapons?
This is a wild card battle role. Anything can happen.
Oh shit. Yeah, but like, why the weapons?
Jesus Christ.
No, JC Lee is out of here.
He kicked him like a jackrabbit and laid on his feet. The amount of just pure, raw, chaotic in the ring, a little bit outside the ring, is just giving off everything.
If Dalton keeps at it, I'm going to have to go out there and take care of him and get him out of there.
And I'm sitting my ass like right here. We've been... Oh.
Get away from the ring, Dalton.
I thought he was about to show
He's hitting him with the wrong side of the kickbox.
That means he's even more painful.
He's hitting him with the handle.
He was hitting him so hard that he fell over.
Oh, my God. Got him right in the knee with that kendo.
That was a well-placed kendo shot. This has turned from a wild card battle royal into a hardcore brawl.
Someone teach King Savage how to use a kendo stick properly, please.
I don't think he cares. This is crazy.
This is turning into a shoot fight.
Sammy Slade with the amateur wrestling Gable Steveson shoot fight special as he now backs King Savage into the corner. And now he has the cookie sheet. I don't like cookie sheet. I like that cookie sheet.
You know, I've never paid attention. You can be one funny motherfucker when you try.
Well, I'm off the cuff right now.
Oh, Jesus.
I take my wrestling seriously, but I like having a good time.
El Mysterioso is still dead on the outside of the ring.
That might be just strategy.
Taking his head off.
That could be just strategy, though.
Nah, I'm pretty sure I gave him a confession.
Yeah, you know what? Fair point. You can do that to people. As now the next entrant is going to come out here.
Oh,
who is
that? Shit.
The final entrant.
You know what? This is the final entrant?
Yes, sir!
Oh, my God. Well, okay, well, there he is. He came here in best what looks to be a Alabama uniform. I guess that's accurate. Atomic Titan, which is so strange for me to say, is here at the Best in the Yard tournament.
Oh, he says he's the best.
Well, I mean, oh, Kurt Adams and Atomic Titan. There are so many potential matchups in this ring and this arena right now.
You got Dalton Skull lurking on the outside of the ring with his Skull Fallout lurking character. Like,
Dalton Skull is lurking like a Scooby-Doo villain. As King Savage now just lunged towards Slade, but now Titan and Slade working together pride style.
Whoa.
Whoa.
You don't want to rephrase that.
Might want to. Wait, what? What's going on here?
What's Skull? Ah, yeah, get him, Skull. Go get Skull. Go get Dalton.
These two are supposed to fight at Adrenaline a few weeks ago, and that didn't happen. I guess they want to get it on right now.
Sullivan, ass, bro.
Super kick, Sammy Slade. There's so much going on. And this is only the first match of this entire show. Now Sullivan is running.
Sullivan don't jiggle. He folds a motherfucker.
He might have folded Dalton Skull on the outside. Accordion, Weird Al style. As now Atomic Titan just straight up right hands Sammy Slade in the face. And another one for King Savage. This is a very, you know, this is like a crack fight matchup like right here. King Savage and Atomic Titan match I never thought I would get to see.
Slash is now corner.
Titan, Bulldog.
Spiked him on that bulldog and he gets a cookie sheet to the head. I'm all over the place with this. Interesting way to get back in the ring there.
I mean, Savage does not give a fuck. Oh, this is gonna be a fight. Now they're fighting. This is what the tournament is all about, fighting. Oh my God!
Gores him in the corner there.
That wasn't gore. That ain't no spear. That's just a straight up gore. Horse Mom, you're here finally. Straight up.
Somebody needs to do something about this. I don't know.
You already left the booth once. Wait.
Damn, oh, Titan. Okay.
You know what? That's a lot like him to do there. I'm gonna put my personal foot inside for this.
Oh! Whiffed the knee strike. There.
I think Savage might have. I think he might have gotten out of the way like in the last second, possibly.
Jesus. Savage with some brutal stomps there.
Stomp straight from Savannah, Tennessee. Damn!
I think
that was just a straight. That was a Mike Tyson punch.
I think Savage would be better suited in a cage, not a ring.
I mean, if UWA goes into any kind of cage, I'll let you know. Higher ups, don't know about that.
I'm sure after taking the world title.
Shit! He barely caught it with a super kick, but he still got the job done.
It worked.
Oh no.
Oh yes.
Oh, you know what?
I'm not even mad to see.
Oh no!
There you go. I ain't even mad to see it.
One more.
Please. The crowd calling for it. I would love to see it.
No. He folded it with the first one. He just. He dead. Did you see that shit?
And Savage
is getting back up. What is Skull doing?
Apparently outrunning Chance.
He Sonic the Hedgehog into the ring. Super speed. Now it's BYCW versus PWF in the ring. What the hell?
What is happening?
He just ran off again. He just took off. He threw him over the... What the hell? Dalton wasn't even in the match. But now both men are. Both men are. What is going on? This is. Okay. You know what? Craziest thing in the world. Okay. He's coming back. Where the hell is he?
I told you someone would have to take care of it. Chance wasn't running out there to get Dalton.
Oh, shit.
I had to get rid of him, man. I had to do it. Not even my battle royal, but I had
Titan
to do it.
Has put down world champions with that knee.
Exchanging blows here.
Exchanging some strikes. I believe this is the final two.
Yeah, and you know what? I, as a proud PWF roster member, I had to get the BYCW trash out of there.
You what?
I had to get the BYCW trash out of there.
Okay, you know what? You know what? I'm not gonna ask. Sammy Slade is now in full control of Atomic Titan. I mean, you got to consider this a big win for PWF. No matter what happens, they've gotten the name out there. Wait!
Sammy Slade's done it!
Wait, hold on a minute!
No! Mysterioso Man wasn't eliminated!
Mysterioso Man!
No!
Whoa!
No!
Whoa!
What the fuck? Here's your winner!
No!
What the hell?
Wait.
He just took off from the back!
I guess we're gonna find out who Mysterioso Man is.
Next, he's still a part of this.
He just stole it.
He's in the first round match against Riley Bates. He won the wild card.
It's time for the tournament now. That was a crazy way to start the show.
Winner's gonna face Kurt Adams in the main event tonight for the Best in the Art Championship.
Not only that.
Thank you. slow up. No, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up. I don't ever slow up. No, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement. I don't ever slow up. No, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement. Everything I do, so instinctive and so passionate. Every word I move, so descriptive like an adjective. I got a vendetta against people who badly be. You should be getting after it. I got facts over tracks. This is nasty. Slow spinning fast. I'm the roast, I can gas. Think I'm okay at last. But I don't blow it back. Can't erase all the past. And the pettiness, a reflection of the emptiness. Hilarious. You think you're worth my time? You're delirious. Mysterious. Because you are behind a thin exterior. Inferior. You know I'll always be a bit superior. Get off of me. This ain't no humble brag. I want you to hear words. You can say them back. I want you to feel free from the chains at last. And to believe in what you got, it was built to last.
Now that I've been living through hell, I never got anyone's help. I had to do it all myself.
I don't ever slow up. No, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement. I don't ever slow up. No, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement.
I'm gonna learn the consequence of being incompetent. Mental health is confidence, dreams into modestness. I'm not here to save the day, that's for you to take away. I could play a million mind games, but instead I say something not illogical, something that is topical. Rub it on and watch it go, make yourself unstoppable. Dreams are irresponsible, but they're always possible. If you just believe, you could be so remarkable.
Thoughts in my head, a collage and they spread. I'll be great one day, going off of my meds. No, I'm not giving up, no, I'm not giving in. I will make it to the top, taking off in the wind. I gotta make it, I'm saving every day to taste it. I'm patient, but my mind, it can hardly take it. I'm chasing a dream that I've had for several ages. A vacant modern kingdom for the taking.
Now that I've been put through hell, I never got anyone's help. I had to do it all myself.
I don't ever slow up. No, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement. I don't ever slow up. No, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up and make a statement. I don't ever slow up. No, I don't take shit. I got no love for the fakeness. If you wanna play tough and wanna hate this, I'll always show up.
I know, I thought you were talking about Pepsi.
Turmoil, Aaron DiCaprio.
No, that's Riley Bates, who's getting ready to come
out. I mean, Bates is coming out. I mean, and you know, he loves his Pepsi.
He is the Pepsi drinking, fourth wall breaking, fallen star.
This is
the one, the only Riley Bates. Or however he fucking says now.
This is taking a little while.
Fourth wall breaking, fallen star, Riley Bates.
What is going on?
The reintroducer's taking a sweet-ass time.
He is. Here comes Bates.
You've been in the ring with Bates before, haven't you?
Recently, yes.
I've
not gotten the pleasure of kicking his ass. Riley Bates, quite frankly, if we talk about purely one-on-one wrestling, I've never seen him in tag team action. If we talk about purely one-on-one pure wrestling, Riley Bates is one of the stiffest contenders you can ever go against. He'll give you a run for your money. I barely beat him, to be honest. I barely beat him in that match.
I don't think I've ever seen him in tag action either, actually.
Well, now he's back in same arena. In the Infinity Arena.
Come on! Where you at? Let me hear you!
It's just Riley Bates, just incredible performer. All around. This is somebody who I think will go far in this tournament if given the right circumstances.
Well, you gotta think, if he wins this round, he faces the winner of CJ versus... Who is CJ facing again in the first round?
I believe he's facing Tristan Taylor.
Oh, yeah. So, Tristan Taylor's going to lose to the Fallen Sons in this entire event. He's going to lose to CJ next round. He's going to lose to me tomorrow.
You know, that's a very grim moment. But, you know, fate has many ways to speak. But Riley Bates is all business. He should be called all business Bates. He is just, he's ready.
All business Bates is what happens in Vince McMahon's office.
You know, this is the one time I'm going to laugh at your joke.
Come on, bring him out here. Let's go.
But Riley Bates is ready to go.
Because you have official Slade. You have honorable official Slade. But we are awaiting the wild card. El Mysterioso.
Wild card battle royal.
The music.
Ladies and gentlemen. Representing
UAW.
What?
This is the wild card.
Wild card.
Haley from
Holy shit! Oh my God!
See? Holy shit!
Kane Ritano!
Holy shit,
I just decked this man?
You just... What the hell? Come on, Bates! Anything can happen!
Holy shit!
Yeah! Pins and flow!
And he's representing UAW!
What? Wow! Okay, that's pretty good, that brand.
Yeah, that's my brand. That's my original brand.
And that's why he's here!
For those of you who don't know, this man is a former UAW World Heavyweight Champion.
The best.
Actually beat me in his debut to win the title.
I was supposed to face this man about a year ago. Fortunately, I didn't get the chance to. I hope one day I do.
Uh-huh. I faced him. I beat him. He's beaten me. It was fun.
But that's not here now. This is right now.
And look at this dream match. Tomorrow's the night of dreams, but look at this dream match.
Don't matter.
Riley Bates and Kaden Ritana, one-on-one.
These two have been at each other's throats on Instagram for years.
This is a year-spanning rivalry. Oh, no! Starting to see it. Bates. Oh.
This is a different attitude from Kaden here.
Not the Kaden Ritana I've been talking to.
Come back a bit more cocky, but Bates is putting the work in on him.
Bates with those forearms. Taking him down. Oh, what was that?
I think he was trying to hit him with a flatliner.
But Bates is not going
to
waste any time. Bates is going to chase him around.
I think he was going for some kind of flatliner, but...
You seeing this?
He's going to follow the orange trip in the...
Oh! Right, there it is. And that's... I mean, we have to acknowledge... Kane Ritana knows his stuff.
He's that,
one of the most cunning people
left to go get some proper schooling done.
I mean, and he's come back sharper than ever. He knows the tricks. He just drives Riley Bates' head straight into the turnbuckle pads. And those turnbuckle pads are not soft. They hurt you.
Indeed, they do. Butterfly! Beautiful butterfly suplex. Oh,
beautiful.
My God.
Bates, that was one of those reactions where, like, that's just a late reaction. He fell down too late. That's how you know that the pain is terrible. Bates. Oh, God.
Referee backing Caden off. Caden, this is a different attitude. I've never seen
this. This is somebody who wants to win. He in the corner.
Christ.
And the audience here, you know, you see some of the competitors.
Everybody's watching on in this spectacle.
They are watching on.
And everybody is firmly behind Bates now. It went from...
Everybody wants Riley Bates.
They went from cheering Caden to hating him in the same breath.
But Bates has to go through one of, if not probably, the most cunning man in this tournament.
I'm not in the tournament. What do you mean?
That's why I said in this tournament. You're not in the tournament.
Sadly. My brother is, though.
I know.
Oh, Caden.
That's a different story. Caden.
Come on, Bates!
Caden.
Beautiful super.
Oh, wow. You see just Bates is just in the corner. He is in pain.
Bates. See, look, they're kicking up on you.
Caden is rocking the Grand Theft Auto San Andreas OG low character.
Look at that. Beth don't even care about you. Look at that.
And you gotta respect him for at least wearing Grove Street colors also.
CFO, it doesn't matter what he's wearing. It matters that he's putting the work into Bates here tonight.
This your ref and you're standing there.
I think Caden Ratana came here to
watch
win.
Watch me kick your
ass. Come back. Cockier and better than ever.
I hate to say it. I was rooting for Riley Bates, but Caden Ratana seems to have this in the bag. Bates in a bad way right now.
Yeah, Bates really hasn't been able to garner much momentum except for right at the beginning of this match.
And Ratana is just playing so many mind games right now. That's so important. Oh, wrestling match. Wait, no!
Bates had it scouted there. Beautiful running chop in the corner there. Forearm strike. And now Bates with an uppercut. Playing with three strikes. Oh, is he going to dome him with it?
Oh, I hate this one. This hurt.
Step up insecurity right there.
That does not feel good. Ratana might be reeling from that one.
Oh, commit for the RPG.
Whoa.
It's Bates says it's over. Oh!
Planted him.
Wow. Riley with the burst of momentum needed to get the job done.
That's the proof of how spontaneous wrestling can be. It can happen in a matter of seconds.
There you saw it. Riley Bates is in for the next round.
That means Riley Bates gets the winner of CJ and Kristen Taylor.
Oh my God.
Think about this.
Caden's homecoming spoiled.
You gotta think that Caden is not happy about that.
And I'm gonna beat
you. Not one
for probably the 1,000th fucking time.
Bates is stumbling a little bit.
And well, I'm gonna have to, I'm going to have to do something you don't like me doing here with this next match coming up, Tristan Taylor versus CJ. I'll be back, buddy.
Well, okay then.
The following contest is a first round match.
Well, folks, there's not really much I can say that you've not heard about CJ.
Introducing first.
I don't know much about Tristan Taylor, but I think this match
is way to the ring from Battleground Wrestling. This is Tristan Taylor.
Whoa. Here he comes. Made his UWA debut recently. Representing Battleground Wrestling is Tristan Taylor. You know, this man is also a man of mystery. We don't really know much about Tristan Taylor. What we do know is that he is a third generation wrestler. He does have some experience in wrestling, and he's very, he's a lot similar to an ultimate opportunist type. Someone who takes his time.
And his opponent.
Speaking of taking time.
Representing UWA. He is your UWA Southern Heavyweight.
We are awaiting the man.
This is CJ.
We are awaiting the man that, quite frankly, if I had to put money on, is probably the most dangerous man I've stepped in the ring with. Probably the most dangerous man in this entire tournament. This man not only fights, he shoots to kill. And that mask on the throne is just, it's almost some bad memories for me. Even in recent times where I've come to almost somewhat respect CJ for how good of a wrestler that he is, I can't help but think every time I see that mask and I hear this music and I see those letters, it's a bad memory for me. I had my highest dream accomplished, but I had to go through a monster to get through it, and I've not been the same since. And that makes you wonder, how will this match affect not only Tristan Taylor, but everybody else in the tournament if CJ is to win? Taylor has to have a miracle here. But if last match is anything to gain, miracles can't happen. Riley Bates defeated Caden freaking Ratana. So anything can happen. But there he is. There's Captain Law.
Crowd is dead as this guy's gonna be.
You see, just crowd is not happy.
Can you play a little more lightly than this?
With these two men.
Oh, you're out here. Cheer this man!
Well, I'll be damned.
Cheer this man! He's your son.
Crowd's a little bit split.
Damn it.
I didn't vote for him.
CJ recently retained the Southern Championship at Adrenaline. And I have to admit, the atmosphere in the locker room after that Southern Championship Fatal 4-Way, there's an atmosphere
music?
Almost like a funeral because three men couldn't stop
music?
Him. What makes Tristan Taylor think he has the means to stop him?
Fuck you.
It will take a miracle for Tristan Taylor to overcome this, but again, anything can happen. Referee.
Ring the bell.
Bell's rung. Okay, now the bell has rung. You see this. Just an eerie presence by CJ.
Sorry, I had to, I had to go out there with it. Whoa, what?
Oh.
Don't touch the belt. You don't hold the belt. Dumbass.
There's some mind games. That's one of the things CJ's good at is playing mind games. It isn't, but Taylor knows that he has to get in the head of CJ somehow. Oh! Oh! Strikes.
There you go, CJ.
Oh my God!
Oh, no. And he's going to get all of this again tomorrow.
This is... Oh, he just twisted his body. He's like, he just contorted him.
There you go, CJ. Work on each one of those limbs, man. All you're going to do is soften them up for me after you beat him.
You know, folks, I don't really have much to say. I've been in the ring with CJ twice. And each time I've come out a different person. I said it in the beginning and I'll say it right now. CJ is the most dangerous man in this tournament for my money. And you see what he's doing now to Tristan Taylor. Taylor came into this match not prepared. Oh.
Yeah, he definitely not prepared.
CJ now. CJ, oh. Taylor. Taylor found a way.
Sadly.
Taylor! This is his chance.
Come on, CJ. Don't make
Taylor's
me regret.
Taylor's now going to have to get some work in. I was just taunting the big man.
Don't make me regret leaving you out there alone.
No. Taylor. Tristan Taylor not going to get to show up. Stuff here. What? Oh. That. Uh-oh.
What the fuck was that?
I think he was trying to bring him down for some kind of complete shot, but that didn't work. CJ just didn't go down, and then I think that might have cost Taylor.
I mean, tall limbs do run strong in our family. We're both tall people.
No.
I mean, look at me. I'm 6'2". CJ's right there with me.
And think about this. Think about who else is in this tournament.
Who?
Think about Riley Bates. He's smaller than CJ.
He's a midget.
Think about Joe Anderson. Think about Dalton Skull.
I mean, so far, everybody that's in this tournament, I know CJ can beat. So.
Oh.
Went for a knee strike there, but Tristan,
that was
for once in his life, had something smartly scouted.
Okay, well, CJ is one of... Actually, he is a dangerous striker, and Law, you know this. You've seen his matches. You've been there with him. He has dangerous strikes. He's gotten so good with those kicks.
I've only ever been once on the end of a K&K, and I'll tell you, I'll never want to do that again.
So you chose the K&K, but even more, how about the shapeshifter?
I'll never take a shapeshifter.
The shapeshifter is the most dangerous DDT that can put somebody out in one hit.
You know what else put face someone wash. Out? That devastating face wash right there. And normally I'd follow that up with Kamata, but CJ just likes destroying his opponents.
CJ is just systematically wearing down Tristan Taylor, and this crowd is not happy.
I am loving that. Fuck the crowd.
You have to think about this. CJ doesn't play to the crowd. CJ tells him to go fall. Slow burn, but Tristan was spiked. Oh, no. Well, who was it?
I mean, you got it. That third generation ring awareness.
He has some awareness. Oh. Kick out. I only dare to imagine what would have happened if he had not been to the ropes the first time. CJ might have just won the match.
No. I am paying attention to anything and everything Taylor does here.
Oh,
Smash
oh,
yes,
oh,
there
oh,
it is.
No.
Break his arm.
Oh my God, he's beating so many people with this move. I've been locked in this move. The amount of pressure that Tristan Taylor must feel right now must be incredible.
Devastating coquina clutch and turns it into a guillotine.
He's transitioning it into a guillotine. Every time he gets in the ring, he just somehow gets better. Oh. Taylor's trying to just mount some punches on him, but the mask always protects it.
I don't think the mask protected that.
Didn't protect that.
That was a pretty
that was
a pretty mean stomp.
Oh! Did he get him with the knee?
Dropped the knee. I think it grazed the forehead.
It grazed the forehead. But CJ found the power to kick out. Now you notice this just feels like a complete tonal shift. Whoa! CJ!
I have a dragon sleeper.
He took him
sir.
Over. I gotta give the devil his due. That was a very beautiful transitional move in wrestling. Oh, Taylor. Taylor broke it. Taylor. He's gonna go for it. Taylor's trying to. Taylor.
King!
No. What's he gonna do?
Oh my God!
No. KK
in the corner.
That's. Oh.
My little brother doing it again.
I have never seen a KK in the corner.
If you ain't ever been trapped by a KK, you definitely seen someone just get trapped by one. There was no escape.
They
that
never see the K and K coming. It's the moment. At one time, it probably still is the most dangerous move in UWA.
Yeah.
You want to know why? It can come from anywhere.
So can a super thick, but you know.
Think about like all the pressure that CJ puts on the K&K. It's a bicycle knee from hell.
And guess what? He raised some hell tonight, and he's gonna take out Riley Bates in the next round.
Yeah, so the next match in the tournament is Riley Bates.
Bates
and CJ.
You're next.
Oh, well, he's serious. He's actually talking.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we do know that Gunshot is not here tonight, and he was supposed to take on Sullivan.
We don't know what happened with him. But, here he comes.
The CBW general manager.
One of my close friends.
This is your buddy.
One of my buddies.
Yeah, I'm his boss.
He was there when I went
underground champion.
Yeah, so was that.
Yeah, fuck you. But
Chase Sullivan.
You gotta think it. What would it mean for Chase Sullivan to win this tournament?
It means he wouldn't get fired from CBW. I told him if he loses this tournament, especially the Gunshot, I'd consider firing.
Well, Gunshot's not here, and he's repping the Underground Championship.
But it would be a little unfair of me to expect him to go through this tournament and beat CJ, because we know he wouldn't be able to do that.
Those two have never crossed paths.
Yeah, but look at him and look at CJ. Come on.
Sullivan is a big man, too. He may not be, like the striker that TJ is, but he can use his power to his advantage.
Well, I've been told that CJ is doing well after his match. Now, Sullivan here is ask for some.
Unfortunately, I've been told that my opponent for this match was not able to show up. See, I was supposed to take on the Anarchist Gunshot. But like I said before, nowhere to be seen. I didn't see him pull up. I didn't see nothing happen except mediocrity because he's scared of me. You see, I want to know who my opponent is. I want to know who I get for the Tennessee Turmoil. I want to know who I am facing right here, right now. Bring him out.
Well, who could it be? Oh, ho-ho.
That's... That's the music of the Best in the Yard champion.
What?
What is Kurt...
What? Why is...
Is Kurt going to be his opponent? That makes no sense. Why would Kurt compete in the tournament where he makes him the winner?
There's Kurt Adams.
Hey, buddy.
There's Kurt Adams.
All right, come on music. Come on music.
Kurt Adams.
Some idiot clapping on the...
What are you doing out here? Your guy didn't show up. What does that say about you, huh? He just didn't want to face you.
Because he's scared of me.
Well, I'll tell you something right now. I'm not going to fight you. I got to preserve my energy. However, I do know who you're going to face. I know who you're going to face one-on-one in this ring for this tournament, for this championship.
Oh, please. Who you got? You got Luchador Gordo? You got Dark Skull? Who is...
I think maybe I need to...
After watching all of your work, we searched far maybe and wide to find anyone
tie my shoes back
really do the job for you. See, don't, in the ring, you're nearly as good as you are on the mic. So I found someone that is going to take you pound for pound, punch for punch, and lay you down 1, 2, 3 on the mat. And move on to the tournament. Ladies and gentlemen, let's bring him out!
I'll be right back.
Wait, what?
What?
I'm not allowed to go?
Oh!
Come on!
Wow!
Let's go!
Come on!
And this has some history! Wow, do you know the history? It was a few weeks back.
Come on, let's go!
Phoenix beat Chase Sullivan. Clean. Clean as a whistle. There's been some tension mounting between the two ever since. Well, I'll be damned.
I gotta wonder if maybe he'll be able to repeat the history. I thought I was going to go.
I
mean,
he is a mutt.
If Canine,
but my mother was
Canine
a pure red,
can
I don't know about yours.
Get the job done. I've been reading both of these men at different times. Sullivan in the jamboree. Canine Phoenix in a one-on-one. Canine is no slouch, neither is Sullivan.
Well,
check it.
I've been in the ring with Sullivan. And I beat him.
Doesn't mean he's not a slouch.
You ready? Yes, I'm ready. Let's go. Let's go.
Bash me over the head with the Dr. Pepper.
Ring the bell.
But now we get a rematch a few weeks ago. Canine Phoenix and Chase Sullivan.
Collar and elbow time.
Oh. And there's the power.
Putting the power on this
Phoenix is a little bit angry at that. Once again. Oh!
You know what?
This is similar.
I wouldn't even be mad if Sullivan lost this match.
It's a tricky thing, you know? Because on the one, like, either man can win, but you know Sullivan has a chip on his shoulder from that loss.
Well, wonder if maybe he can get his win back here tonight.
Oh!
I got a taste out of his mouth. I like seeing that. Blade did it to him. I don't like Blade. I like Sullivan. Slap the taste out of Sullivan's mouth.
Sullivan! Oh my god!
He put everything behind that DDT.
That was a big man's DDT.
Jake Roberts would have been proud of that one.
Indeed he would have. Now K9 is a little bit rocked after that DDT. Sullivan just shoves him back in the corner. This is one of Sullivan's main offense points. He loves to get people in the corner just to punish them. No!
K9. Went for that. Went for a double chop. K9 now laying in. Forearm strike.
Them big strikes from the Gulf Coast. Big splash.
The Gulf Coast pound. Oh, shit.
Oh, he's hit the drop kick.
He actually hit the drop kick that time.
And that was smart by K9 Phoenix. He let everybody, he gave people a hustle just to get, wait, Phoenix, I'm trying to get the ankle lock in. But no.
Sullivan had it scouted this time. What
Phoenix.
Is
Phoenix. Phoenix.
Phoenix.
Phoenix. Phoenix. Oh. Oh.
Even I was disappointed that that didn't
We could have seen a suicide dive right then and there, but Sullivan just swatted like a damn fly out of midair.
Or as I call it, a tope suicina.
Suicina. Interesting. As now Sullivan.
Oh!
Give me that here.
Do it again! One more time!
I heard it on the monitor, in my headphones, and in the ring.
We're backstage.
That rang out.
And some refreshments.
I already drank my Coke. I was told I couldn't have another one.
I had Dr. Pepper. Oh, so, oh, once again.
Get the Kabachi!
Oh!
There you go, Phoenix. Okay.
K9. A
little bit of
what's
Japanese.
K9 thinking? No.
A little bit of strong style.
Some dog style. Some doggy style here.
Whoa.
What? He's a dog.
Wrong luck.
Oh, goodness. Red basket knee strike from Sullivan, and the underground champion is now just teeing off.
Wrong platform for the dog.
Oh. Well, I mean, technically, he's canine things. He can kick a doggy style like that whenever he wants. Wait, Phoenix, turns him over. Oh my God!
He got the ankle lock in. He's gonna grapevine it though.
This is one of the most painful moves I've ever been in. Sullivan gets the rope.
I gotta think if he'd have grapevined that, Sullivan wouldn't have had an opportunity to get to the ropes.
Sullivan might have. How he jammed the knee like beforehand. Sullivan might have just tapped.
I have been in an ankle lock before. I can promise you it does not feel good.
You ever been in a canine Phoenix grapevine ankle?
No, I'll never let him hit me with the grapevine ankle.
I said that before our match, but he still got me. Now,
well, you're a lot worse off than I am. So,
you go fuck yourself. As now, Phoenix is
one
just
more.
Completely
yeah.
in control. Oh.
Beautiful back senton.
That
there.
Was beautiful. Good job, Phoenix. One.
Whoa.
That was a one.
Phoenix is a relative newcomer to the.
Whoa!
Ref not in position. Get in the pitfall, ref.
Sullivan could have had that match won.
Referee Slade not.
Slade a little bit slow right now. I hate to say it, but law that Sullivan. Sullivan got him down for 3 seconds. There's just no count.
I didn't see 3 seconds.
It's either 2.5 or 3. It was close. Now these two men just teeing off on each other. Weeks of tension built up to this point. Oh no!
Throws him into the turnbuckle there.
Almost like a self lawn dart. It's Chase Sullivan. That's like Godzilla coming towards you.
Get him off me! Get him off me! Get him off me!
Just making K9 eat his boot like a bone.
Like a bone.
Now, I'm going to be a little punny here. I say Sullivan has a bone to pick with K9.
Funnily enough, I was going to say that too, Law. Bone to pick.
I'd say great minds think alike, but I'm the only great mind on the table. So.
Well, you're wrong. But, Oh no. Sullivan is just completely targeting the breadbasket sternum area. But that's not, no, it's not all. Sullivan's getting frustrated.
But you got to think, and no one's really done this. You got to conserve your energy. Both of these guys do, because if they make it to the next round.
I mean, CJ kind of did it.
I mean, CJ put Tristan Taylor away.
Because he knew that he has to conserve the energy, but these guys are going a little bit longer. What is this? Well, I mean, he caught him.
I'd call that a natural selection, but it definitely wasn't. More of a blockbuster.
Natural.
More of a reverse blockbuster.
Kind of shades of Mr. Perfect. In a sense.
You know what? You're not wrong there.
It, like, because Perfect did that move a little bit. But as.
And I would know a natural selection when I see one. You felt one. So.
Wait. Whoa. Wait. No. Sullivan.
Oh, I'm blocking it.
We could have seen a flip pile driver, but Sullivan straight just lifts him down. The strength of Chase Sullivan.
You know, went for a bit of a Panama sunrise there, but Sullivan could be looking for the infringement.
Infringement.
Lined up.
Whoa!
Didn't sit out with it, though.
He didn't sit out with it. I think he might want to try it again. Sullivan knew he didn't quite catch it. He might. Uh-oh. Infringement?
Oh, there it is. And that
cover.
Might be it, folks.
That is all.
Oh, Sullivan goes on to the next round to face the winner of Dalton Skull and his opponent, Joe Anderson. Think about this, Jake, and I know you've been there for the entire story. What if this tournament comes down to CJ and Joe Anderson?
Well, I was retired.
All day.
When they had their series of matches, I was backstage looking over things, and that tore the arena apart, the locker room apart, tore everything apart. If it came down to those two men in the final, the Turmoil tournament might just get torn apart with the hatred that they have for one another.
We gotta get through Dalton Skull and
Joe Anderson.
Joe Anderson first.
Now, let's think about this. These are two completely different style of wrestlers right here.
Indeed. You got the hardcore, ruthless, fast.
You have a risk taker
in Dalton Skull.
You know, and we saw what Skull could do early in the Battle Royal.
Even though he wasn't part of the Battle Royal.
He still did a number of damage on mobile people. Skull.
You gotta wonder if maybe that'll come into play.
Dalton Skull.
Hey, get away from us.
Dalton Skull did suffer that leg injury with Aaron Blaze. However, he looks to be in good tip-top shape.
It's the only thing I'll ever say Blaze did right.
Going into this match, he's in tip-top shape. I think you have to be for something kind of like this. This tournament is a... And law part of this will come down to endurance.
You know, you've got a point, and I'll reluctantly agree with you there, but...
The more well-conditioned athlete will excel in this tournament. The ones who pace themselves and the ones who do their damnedest to get the victory, they will come out on top.
Anderson!
Folks...
And you heard it from the ring announcer, the Lone Wolf. This man isn't representing any particular brands here tonight.
Not at all. He's coming in with himself.
But, you know, I've got to say this man is a former TBW World Heavyweight Champion. A TBW World Champion at one point in his career.
He was the first UWA World Heavyweight Champion.
Indeed he was. I was getting to that.
This man is no stranger to winning long-form matches. He won the Underground Unleashed Battle Royal to become the first world champion. He went through so much during his title reign, only taken out by CJ, and now he's come back here with somewhat of a vengeance. I know he wants to win this tournament. Joe is that type of guy.
He's won mid-card titles. There's that fast pace of Dalton Skull.
Now you see the difference. Joe Anderson is more... you know, biting and patient. Dalton Skull was a rabid, you know, like rabid dog, padded vest with Joe Anderson.
Oh, Jesus. Those strikes of Dalton Skull were getting nowhere.
So where Skull has speed, Joe has power, and Joe just flung into the rope. Whoa. Slashed him and caught him down.
Torture rack position. Okay, Joe.
Big knee to Dalton Skull. Skull's kind of still selling that leg a little bit from the Aaron Blaze match. Dalton Skull. Oh, my God. Springboard knee drop to the Grim Reaper.
And a springboard coffin drop.
Wow. Innovative offense from Dalton Skull. Well,
Dalton is mildly impressing me tonight.
Dalton is one of Joe's throwing meat hooks. Joe is throwing meat hooks. Anderson sweeps the legs of Skull.
That leg, though.
Go for the leg. He faked him out the last minute. Now just laid the leg on top of the Skull of Dalton. Now going to the side of the ear. That is a dangerous place to go. Might have damaged the cartilage on his ear, which can happen. Oh, Skull!
Alrighty.
Skull with a hang kick. Skull on the apron. Joe's dazed. Springboard! Wow!
I'm not sure if that was a springboard clothesline or a springboard forearm, but it was effective nonetheless.
It was springboard effective strike is what that was.
Now dropping that knee into
the abdomen.
Abdomen of Joe Anderson. I don't know. I mean, Dalton
he did not come here to play.
Dalton's setting up for the last resort.
No. Joe. Oh shit.
Jesus. Beautiful flatliner.
Now last resort. Dalton Skull coming for the last resort. He could hit it. He put down a number of great competitors with this move.
Cut the life into pieces.
Oh! Joe with a spear! Holy shit! Oh my God! The crowd is on Joe Anderson's side. The smoke fills the arena. Joe! Skull is hilarious! Oh God!
Dalton getting picked apart. Joe had the last resort knee scouted.
Look at the power.
Dalton
inside out.
Dalton looks like he's got some tape on the ropes in his head.
Not even bouncing off the rope. Joe. Oh. Law. You seeing Dalton?
I'm seeing
Dalton Skull kick out.
I'm seeing a prospect in Joe Anderson.
I'm seeing just a match and a half. No matter what happens in this match so far, this will go down in this arena as one of the better matches I've ever personally seen.
Dalton picking the knee.
Targets the.
Sliding flatliner there.
I'm at a loss for words.
Dalton.
I'm at a loss for words.
Dalton could be tuning it up for the last resort. Cut the life into pieces.
Joe!
Had it scouted again into a spin-out spinebuster.
Dalton Skull goes for the last resort. Joe Anderson has an answer.
That was a modified spinebuster there. Kind of
almost a year on.
Kind of spun him out a little bit in it, too. But Joe.
Count him out.
Joe telling the ref to count him out.
Dangerous for Dalton Skull. Joe Anderson is now given time to rest. And the last thing you want staring face to face in the ring is a well rested and well prepared Joe Anderson.
You're a pussy.
Now Dalton.
You're a pussy.
The crowd against. Dalton smartly breaking the count.
Dalton knows. If Dalton is anything, he is a cunning opportunist.
Oh, now that cunning opportunity. Come back to bite him in the ass.
Hit him in the ass like Forrest Gump in a bullet. Now Joe Anderson. Joe's tired of playing games.
Indeed.
Joe. Look at the big splash. Dalton.
Dalton lining it up.
Dalton, last resort.
Oh my God.
Last resort.
What's Dalton?
I think he got him. I don't think that the pin would have mattered. He knocked him straight out with that last resort.
I don't think the ref was paying attention to the foot on the ropes either there.
Wait, so does this mean?
That means Dalton goes on to face
Sullivan.
Sullivan.
So we get... Oh, no.
Oh.
Yo. Oh, well, you know what? That's show respect. Joe knows. I got to give it up to him. That was a performance and a half from both men. Joe Anderson did such a good job, but at the end of the day, Dalton Skull. And that's in that trouble. He is hurt.
Oh, he outran Sullivan in the Battle Royal. I don't think he's going to have that same opportunity in the next round.
Think about this. Sullivan is going to be well-rested. Dalton Skull has now, he's like a adamant injury. How's that going to affect him? But now, we get to one of the most interesting matches of this entire tournament.
See, you were able to take out Riley Bates.
Semi-final match.
At Adrenaline.
Yeah.
You think CJ has got... I know CJ has what it takes.
Okay.
You think CJ has what it takes.
I will admit, by the skin of my teeth, I barely beat Riley Bates. And I'll admit to me, you know, at Finalist Nation when I faced CJ, he got me pretty hard. Both of these men have a fighting spirit like probably no other. They will not let the odds get to them. Now, this probably has to come down to who, I guess, who is going to sacrifice more in this match. That is the key.
You got to think, both of these men have had matches already once today. It shows, too.
Both of these men finish their opponents off in a quick manner. They both are a little bit well-rested. They have some time to kind of take a seat, take a step back, and, you know, rest their body, but wrestling can get you really fast. If you don't pace yourself, you will get blown up, and you will get gassed, and you will probably, you're going to make some mistakes.
Well, Riley has holes in his game, and I think CJ is going to exploit those.
Well, CJ's not really perfect either.
Don't talk about my brother.
No, I mean, I'm just going to be honest with you. CJ, there have been times where he's miscalculated the move so much that he's almost lost some of the most high-profile matches in his entire career.
Key word, almost.
I'm just saying, for as many, you know, of these so-called, you know, strategy holes that you think that Blaze, you know, Blaze almost beat CJ at Destiny.
Somebody cutting Riley's music.
Somebody cut his music, but for both these men have holes in their offense. And if either one can capitalize, we're going to see a winner.
Shades of old UWA, people cutting off the music for CJ.
You know what? That's a good point. Before the old sound team was beaten up by CJ, they made a lot of mistakes.
It wasn't just CJ. Why do you think I had to come in and help CJ? Take over the soundboard for a little bit, you know. Had to do what I had to do.
Well, that's in the past.
You know what else is going to be in the past? Riley's opportunity facing Kurt Adams in the main event of this tournament after he loses the season.
Listen, we can't count Bates out. As much as you want to be biased towards your brother, we can't count Riley Bates out. Riley Bates is one of the best wrestlers that has stepped foot in this entire arena and since this entire tournament. Riley Bates, if he is to beat CJ, it's an uphill battle, but he can do it. If he is to face Kurt Adams, I believe... If I'm not mistaken, I could be wrong, but Riley Bates has beaten Kurt Adams before, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Riley Bates has beaten Kurt Adams before. He knows what it takes to beat Kurt Adams. He knows what it takes to get into Kurt Adams' head. However, I can't discount CJ either. Kurt Kurt Adams can rest all night. But if CJ is to make it to the finals, nothing can prepare for that kind of freight train mentality of CJ.
And, you know, I don't even need to come out with CJ this time around. No. That's how much faith I have going to take out right here.
No. No matter what, this whole tournament, you got to remember who this is for.
Indeed.
I think that no matter what we argue about or bicker over, I think that Nova would have enjoyed the...
I think Nova would have loved to have been a part of this himself.
He's still here. He's going to be all around us.
You know, mayday, mayday, the ship is slowly sinking.
A little bit.
They don't know the feeling.
They don't.
Just like the song says, they're all around us, circling like vultures, and tonight CJ looking to peck away at Riley
Bates.
Bell's
rung. If we approach this from an analytical stance, Bates is the smaller but faster of the two. CJ is the dangerous striker.
Bates also took a lot more damage.
He did.
From CFR than CJ took from Tristan.
So CJ is the more well-rested of the two. His body is not in as much pain as Bates might be. Oh, Bates?
Eyeing the Southern title.
I mean, I'd like to see that match in different places. We're going to get it right now. Collar and elbow. No, maybe not. Maybe not.
No. Bates is so short, he wasn't able to get the collar and elbow up on CJ.
I think you're turning it into some kind of clothesline, but CJ caught that too. Oh, wow. He pushed him back with a lot of force. Bates. Oh, no.
Now we get to see some technical wrestling from CJ as he works on the arm of Riley Bates.
And you got to think about this. Most of Riley Bates' signature match-ending moves involve the arms. Arm locking. Arm holding it in place. If his arms are useless, he can't win with that.
Indeed, he won't be able to hit the world wide if he can't spin you around. He can't arch you over for the RPG. He can't do anything if he's knocked out from being choked on the ropes.
The only thing that I could see is if he used his, you know, he used a bit of thought and a little bit of, you know, risk to get CJ down. That'd be the only way he can beat him.
Well, right now, CJ is continuing to work on that arm.
The right arm. This is what CJ does best. He isolates what he thinks you need the most. And he's going to capitalize on it.
Bates working smartly. You obviously see the other competitors sitting around too.
His arm is turning a little red from all this work.
Yes, I know it's a count of four. Yes.
That's how you know.
There's a jet ski in the arena.
Well, you got to consider the head of the board of UWS. Wait,
hey.
No!
Oh my God! Devastating DDT there. And now working on the arm once again.
Almighty, that... Oh, no, that gives bad flashbacks.
Surfer 8.
Oh, my God.
Might be the reason. That might have been Surfer 8's...
How many monkeys are there? Okay, the monkeys aren't important.
Yeah.
CJ and Smart by CJ. He hit the DDT, working the neck. Now he's working the neck even with the dragon slip. No!
Riley able to turn it into a chin. Chin, jawbreaker, same thing.
Come on, Riley!
Either way,
got the job done.
Crowd now rooting for Riley Bates.
I mean, he's the underdog in this match. Working on the legs. And now think about this, where CJ worked on the arms. CJ needs his legs to hit the K and to really hit the shapeshifter. And Bates is just targeting them.
Come on, CJ. How are you going to let a Keebler elf beat you up?
I said it earlier, I want to say it again. It's not the size of the dog in the fight. It's the size of the fight in the dog.
Oh!
Oh my God!
And that's his hurt knee. So his right knee has always been a little bit hurt.
A double stomp to it.
On that knee. Oh.
And on the rope. And on the rope.
I know you're gonna hate me for saying this, but CJ might have lost right then and there if not for the rope. The rope might have saved his ass. Oh, Bates. Bates. Oh.
Oh, God.
Even with a hurt knee and the pressure mounting on him, he still manages those dangerous kicks and strikes.
You see, even though he hit that boot, he's grasping that
he
leg.
He's limping.
I don't think he was still able to put all of the force behind that boot.
But even half of CJ's force is enough.
Indeed.
I had to give the devil his due, but CJ was the best competitor I've been in the ring with.
Now CJ has Bates in the corner there.
Oh no.
Oh, and that chop rings out loud.
And you can see just the red marks appearing all over Riley Bates' body. No, Bates! Gut. Bates is teeing off on CJ once again. This time he's going to give some of his own medicine. Oh!
It's hard for me to watch my brother getting beat up like this, man.
Bates in the corner. Uppercut to this. I mean, he couldn't reach the face, but back also on his knees.
I've been told I'm not allowed to get up off the table during this match.
So not to be biased. That would. I mean, I know you. You would distract Riley Bates.
Yeah.
And you'd spoil Bates' chances, but this is going to be a fair wrestling match.
Gotta get the best in the yard type of the mafia somehow.
No, hold on a second. Oh, no. Bates. What is Riley Bates doing?
Frog Splash! The Fallen Star Frog Splash.
That wasn't no falling star. That was a fucking meteor heading towards the earth. He was... torpedoed himself on a CJ, but he's not making the cover.
They don't call him the Fallen Star for no reason. Whips him into the corner.
Bates should have covered him after that.
Bates with that running chop.
Riley struck to the shoulder.
Could be looking to set up the same way.
To the chin.
Same way he did CFR, sweeps the leg. Could be looking for that step up in Seguri.
That rocked Caden.
Rocked Caden enough for him to hit the RBT.
Wait, no, no, no,
CJ
no.
Blocks it.
No, no.
Come on, Bates.
No.
I don't know what's wrong. Bates is tired. Oh. Bates is tired. No, no, no.
Oh, God.
But Bates.
I don't think he got full force of that KMK, but he's going to get the full force of the shapeshifter crumpling the legs underneath Bates. There we go.
Here is your winner, the
UWA
Southern Heavyweight Champion, CJ.
That was... Oh, my God.
CJ doing it again.
I just can't... My brain's broken. That was one of the most devastating shapeshifters, if not the most devastating shapeshifter I've ever seen.
That tends to happen when someone drops you on your head on top of the title.
I felt the shapeshifter just go off.
Yeah. It plants you on your head.
It does.
We have a slogan at the Midwest Mafia.
Look at this. Everybody has come to help out Riley Bates. I'm being told now Riley Bates is going to be rushed to a medical facility.
That's going to really suck for him tomorrow, Jason Sullivan.
If he can make it tomorrow, then.
Well, speaking of Sullivan.
Well, DiCaprio, it's kind of funny. This match was supposed to happen at Adrenaline.
No casket.
I don't think that they need a casket. They're fighting for more than just the Underground title. Although the Underground title is 24/7, could potentially change hands in this match like 55 times alone.
Well, I've also been informed that the typical rules for championships have been suspended.
Oh no.
Tonight, because this isn't a certain brand. You know, this is everybody coming together for Nova. So I've been told that the Underground Championship 24/7 capabilities have been suspended for this match.
Dalton is not looking good.
Nursing the knee and the abdomen.
Joe's spear did so much to him. It might be just the story of this whole match. Think about Sullivan.
Wait, Sullivan's not...
And his opponent...
This isn't a CBW.
You can't just change things, can you? Oh.
I mean,
I've heard this music several times.
He doesn't need a gimmick, so he isn't iconic right now.
I think this is no gimmicks needed.
Still representing CPW, but obviously the...
Now, the ankle from K9 Phoenix obviously hurt. Both of these men are hurt. Dalton can't even barely stand right.
Well, it doesn't help. You gotta wonder what they did to each other when Sullivan chased them out of the Battle Royal, too. We didn't get a camera back here.
I mean, the event promoters, they didn't think that they
need one.
I don't think that they would have needed one. Though, I'm being told a little bit right now that what reported to happen was Sullivan did take a lead pipe to Dalton Skull's abdomen.
Oh.
So that says a lot. About what's going to happen right here.
And if you notice, every time we've seen King Savage, Dalton Skull has been by his side. But where is Savage for Dalton?
Well, after the Battle Royal, Savage is currently... Savage is injured, but that's not the story. That tells the entire story right there.
Savage going after that ankle of Sullivan.
It's true. Skull is just completely working that entire left, or well, right. Doesn't matter. The leg is just fucked. He's working on the fucked up leg. Any wrestler knows that's a smart game. That is smart. It is not morally right. Oh God. I think for as much as Dalton Skull is giving, how much is he taking? In return.
Well, I mean, Dalton's not afraid to put himself at risk for a move. He is a charismatic enigma in the ring.
You know, I like only one of those words that you just said. Anyway, Dalton Skull has been in full control ever since the bell rang. Sullivan is heavily nursing that left leg.
You gotta wonder how much of that injury that Dalton has is legitimate.
Oh my god!
Jesus! Oh God Almighty! What a forearm strike!
Holy shit!
Striking him all over the body, focusing some of those strikes on the abdomen.
That's what we mean when Sullivan. He's a dangerous wrestler. He can be a really dangerous wrestler. Oh!
He got that knee up, but you got to think how much that took out of his own knee.
That bought him some time, but that might have dug his grave a little bit too.
All right, come on, Dalton. Come on.
You got to think, this type of match, this type of tournament, you could be putting your own nail in the coffin.
And just think about this narrative too. A tournament is where careers are either made or ended. These type of matches and this type of tournament could add or take years from your career.
You know, I hate to agree with you, but you're right.
Think about this for a second. Dalton Skull is fighting with everything that he has, but that might shorten his career. Same with Chase Sullivan. Same with CJ. wrestling is so unpredictable that we don't know anything can happen. Skull! Oh my god!
Springboard splash there. But
he turned into a crossbody, but that did more damage to Dalton Skull than did Chase Sullivan.
Indeed, I mean, that abdomen, I might have said that it was might not have been completely real, but you got to think maybe there is some there. Now, Sullivan not able to put all the force behind his kicks because he can't plant.
Oh, God.
He can't plant on that leg.
And you got to think that CJ is watching right now and he's just laughing. Oh! Last resort! Or maybe like a variation of the last resort knee.
And Dalton could be lining up for a second one.
Another one. I think he knows this. Like the old story of going bear hunting. It takes more than one shot to kill the giant grizzly. And it can take more than one shot to get Chase Sullivan. No!
Oh! Went for a bicycle kick but caught the referee.
He caught the referee. Oh, no. Sullivan. Wait! Oh, wait!
Dalton, that's a crutch.
Hey! Oh no!
A clutch to the bad leg of Sullivan. Wait, Sullivan. Sullivan getting a toy of his own.
But had Skull it scouted. Caught it. Skull caught.
Cookie tray to the head.
This has been building for weeks between these two men.
What?
What is. Wait!
Wait! Wait!
Hey!
Wait. Hold on!
Hey, wait a minute!
Skull Center went back to me.
Had to get up off the table for that one.
Jesus.
Holy shit. But that comes down to the finals of CJ and Dalton Skull, the winner.
I had to jump out of my shoes.
Winner getting the memorial plaque and then facing Kurt Adams for the best in the
They're still trying to separate him.
I mean, even Riley Bates came out there. I thought he was supposed to be at a medical facility.
Ladies and gentlemen,
I think they were loading him into the ambulance.
All hands on deck, I guess.
And this is the finals.
Well, the fight has been stopped.
Introducing first,
Sullivan is in the other room, in the arena.
He is.
But
Dalton
it's.
Skull.
Well.
It's finals time.
It's finals time, which means I'm gonna take a drink of my drink here, and then I'll see you in a bit.
What? You can't go out for this.
No reason.
Are you going out there?
I'm gonna let Dalton do his entrance. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm not doing anything.
You answer all this. Do whatever you want to do. I don't care. Dalton Skull, it was smart what he did last round. He pulled a classic wrestling trick and it bought him some time and bought him some energy. That brawl, fans didn't see that brawl in the back a little bit. Skull got rocked in the head.
Hey, Jake, I'll see you in a bit.
Okay. And now, and this is what's happening. This is, without a shadow of a doubt, this is going to say so many things about both men, no matter who wins this match. This match is about courage and fortitude. Dalton Skull, fighting through injury. CJ barely fazed by anything. Bates might have injured his bad knee, but that doesn't mean that CJ can't prepare. Everybody was pulled out for that brawl between Sullivan and Skull. But CJ understands the matter of pushing yourself. It matters so much.
Representing UWA.
He's now
the UWA Southern Heavyweight
just waiting.
And accompanied to the ring by the
waiting.
WCW Anarchy Champion.
Apparently there's still some problems going on backstage.
And
Law did get up from the commentary table.
CJ.
Both, you know, this says so much. Well, there's me. I don't really matter here. CJ can do, what on the Tron, he did a Dalton Skull, just to me, you get it. I'm at a loss for words at what I had to go out there and do. And Captain Law, wearing the BCW Anarchy Championship, this is the final. You would have thought that Nova would have liked to see this final. Maybe not the brawl that just took place. That's not what wrestling is all about. But this match might just be what wrestling is all about. That's heart and soul and courage and everything.
Cheer your Southern champion!
But now, as we see it, this, quite frankly, is one of the most important matches that has ever taken place in this arena. This is for Nova. Nova's friends, family, as a tribute to him. The winner does receive the plaque dedicating this entire tournament to Nova. Referee Santiago now showing both men the beautiful plaque. One of these men gets to take that plaque home. Maybe, just maybe, one of these men will take the best in the yard title belt. But you got to keep in mind that Kurt Adams is completely rested. He has not done one physical thing besides breaking the brawl apart. This match is going to be something that, quite frankly, is going to just to blow the roof off the entire joint.
You good to go?
Yeah.
You good to go?
Bell is rung. Bell has been rung. Both men have their own setbacks, but Dalton Skull is worse for wear. CJ is at full capacity.
You say that.
Brothers are talking amongst each other. You have to thank folks. And the winner of this match does go on. Face Kurt Adams, no! Basement dropkick targets the injured knee. CJ, now Dalton Skull is just wailing on. Those are fancy wrestling strikes. They just shoot strikes. Now, kneeling on the knee, trying to cause as much damage as he can. CJ, maybe he's a bit more banged up than I personally thought. He's clutching that knee. Skull running boot to the knee. Oh, Captain Law not getting on the apron. CJ picks him up, manhandles him, puts him corner big, just thunderous punches. Crowd's not a fan of that. Neither am I a fan of that. This is about more. This is about respect for Nova. That wasn't respect. That was just blatant cheating.
Soon to be Mr.
Best. Oh, shut up, you skin faced dog. You straight up just. It's not what Nova would have wanted for you to do. Either way, the match is going to continue now. It's Dalton Skull initiates the collar and elbow tie-up, but CJ is clearly a little bit stunned from that. Whips CJ off the rope. Spin kick takes him down. I have to indulge in a little bit of food here. This has been a starving type of tournament. It's crazy what's going on here. It's now Dalton Skull sends the rope and just plants his knee. on the injured knee of CJ. I just have to point out. Whoa! That was just beautiful. But I want to just give right now respect to everybody that has been in the tournament. Kate Ratana, Joe Anderson, K9 Phoenix, Chase Sullivan, Riley Bates. All of them put forth an effort. This is the final. This is the whole shebang. Winner goes on to face Kurt Adams. But Dalton Skull is just gang style, curb stomping the knee. Now setting up and just trying just to jam that knee into the canvas. Dalton Skull is looking maniacal. CJ is in a very vulnerable position. Even Captain Law can see. But CJ is in a bit of a world of hurt. Skull is running off of adrenaline. Oh, God.
Hey, ref.
Now.
Turnbuckle pads looking a little loose, man.
What's going on here? Law! Law!
Law!
Distraction and a con device. He stomps it to get some more pressure. He's far away from the ropes. He's falling the ropes. Law's pulling the ropes back, but he still reached the rope.
What?
No. Now Skull just decked CJ. Just decked him. To get out of that submission hold. We've been an update. Real quickly on Riley Bates. The brawl he's been taking in the facility. Sullivan is going to take the arena. As Dalton Skull continues to work over the hurt knee of CJ. The referee is checking. Dalton. Dalton just punching him once again. Captain Law looks like he can't do anything. He can't risk for his own ego getting ejected from this match, because that means CJ is at an even less of an odds of winning this contest. Skull's collapsing. I think that burst of adrenaline might be over. CJ's getting to his feet. Uppercut!
There you go. There you go, Cal. Come on, Cal.
Uppercut. That was out of nowhere. That might have bought CJ some good time. And now CJ is going to just, now he's getting to work on the arm. A little bit of moral payback for CJ. Now, you know, Captain Law has to be happy watching his brother stand tall. He is. Now, CJ and Dalton Skull get into a battle of kicks, but CJ's more powerful kicks stopped him. Dennis tracks! Big boot. It's this type of energy that made CJ undefeated for nearly an entire year.
One!
Holding the UWA World Championship for
two!
Damn near 7 minutes.
Three! Hey, get
and
back
now,
in here, CJ!
CJ axe handle.
Four!
Skull! Oh, no! 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 He might have just crushed the larynx of Dalton Skull on the edge of the ring apron.
Come on, ref, check on CJ.
Skull.
What?
He's hurt. Check on him.
Clutching his throat.
Are you good to continue?
Clutching
look,
the throat.
Look, he'll be fine. No, check his knee. Check his knee.
That's going to cut off the air. Oh, Captain Law.
You need to call the man.
Stomping on him. That's not fair.
Obviously.
The man might already have his throat somewhat crushed.
Are you able to continue? Yeah.
And this gutless prick has the nerve? Hit that man when he's just down? That's bullshit. CJ, Dalton tried, going swinging, big swing. That made both men dizzy. Both men are now down. Both men are down.
One!
So, wait!
Two!
Sullivan's back in the arena!
Three!
Sullivan's back in the arena!
Four!
He's watching this contest. Maybe he's here just trying to even the odds.
Six!
Sees all this blatant cheating.
Get up, Dalton!
Captain Law has been doing.
This is what
what you wanted, Dalton.
Mind your business. You have, you've already
Sullivan.
Hey.
Skull's flipping him off.
KK! KK! The cover! Cena's won the best in the yard tournament. With a distraction from Chase Sullivan. CJ won the best in the yard tournament.
He won.
The Aaron DeCaprio Memorial Tournament.
You won.
Holds the black, but the night is not over. Keep in mind, he still has to face Kurt Adams, a fresh Kurt Adams.
The winner.
He has to face a fresh Kurt Adams. Oh, goodness. That was a match in a half. You got to feel for Dalton Skull. He worked so hard. Now, I guess it's time. We're just going to do this right now. I think I'll be watching this match very closely, too. I take on this man tomorrow. Use this time to scout. Point is, just after the insanity that was this tournament, there is the best in the yard champion, Kurt Adams, fresh face, resting all night. Apparently, in the back, he had
what it's all about.
You know, some nice refreshments. His own locker room, they pampered him up all night. And now he finally gets to step into the ring against an albeit very battered, very broken, very tired CJ. Captain Law now trying to school CJ on Kurt Adams. These two men have a history together, which being Law and Adams, whether it's invading Indiana or anything after, or anything even before. Each team had a personal history. It's Kurt Adams. Makes his way to the ring. You gotta think that vicariously Captain Law is living through CJ. Because I know he wants to beat Kurt Adams.
He already won the plaque.
CJ is already the winner of the Aaron DeCaprio tournament. But if he beats Kurt Adams right here.
You ready? Are you ready? Ring the bell!
That makes him the best in the yard. The bell's rung. Adams immediately going after the hurt knee. Fast and furious from Kurt Adams. Sexy bearded god. Jamming the knees.
What the man punch me like that?
Just stretching the knee. Stretching the tendons. Ow. CJ's in a bad way already and the match has just started. Adams is now just wrenching the tendons. Trying to pull the muscles. Tear the muscles of CJ. CJ's just writhing around in complete pain. As Kurt Adams now floats over, half crab. Into Lance Storm.
All right, good. One, two,
CJ reaches the ring. I've never seen CJ, never mind. Uppercut to Kurt Adams. Corner, big boot. Takes Kurt Adams down. Kurt Adams is down. CJ standing up on the hurt knee. Bulldog! Driving the forehead and face of Kurt Adams into the canvas. One, two, no. It'll take more than that to put Kurt Adams down. CJ. Sizing up. Oh, shades of his brother. Shades of his brother. Now CJ. What's he doing here? Ripcord Rainmaker! But that's not all!
Two!
Kurt Adams kicked out of the Rainmaker, the short arm clothesline, whatever you want to call it. Kicked out of it.
Come on, CJ.
You can see just how much his head is hurting. That's very interesting to me personally. But his head's hurting him. Both men getting to their feet. He's stunned, Kurt Adams and CJ. Both men are stunned.
Open hand.
Dazed and confused.
Fuck your open hand. Punch it.
I don't think Kurt Adams has ever faced anybody like CJ, and vice versa.
There you go, CJ. Come on. Talk to me.
It's a match you would only see at an event like Tennessee Turmoil. A match you would only see.
Take your
under special circumstances, and these circumstances are special.
Remember, he's not dead.
CJ works on the left arm, but that knee is just killing him. This will now come down to a battle of wits and a battle of endurance. As Adams and Law smart off one another. CJ gets time to rest as Adams is just completely. He's favoring his arm. If CJ sees that, he might go for the Kimura. Or an arm bar or something, just try to capitalize. Oh! Referee! Referee didn't see it. Referee didn't see it. DDT. Referee didn't see. No, this can't be it. No. Adam stays alive.
Two count.
But Adam stays alive. In this match for the best in the yard championship. What would it mean for Kurt Adams to beat a man who has only been beaten in singles action once? But then again, what would it mean for CJ to defeat Kurt Adams?
No, taste of that.
Who is so
Northern.
Dominant
Northern.
In his own neck of the woods.
Come on.
Kicks now.
No,
those kicks.
No.
And Kurt Adams has no kick pass. That means that they hurt even more. But CJ, dragon screw.
There you go.
Scoped it out before it even began. CJ.
Oh, shit.
Now, Adams is just down. CJ is also down. And some kicks of his own. Teeing off like Happy Gilmore on a golf green. Big boot to Kurt Adams. That was almost like a sniper shot to the head. You will. And CJ in the corner. Be looking for the K&K. Or even the shapeshifter. Or something. Adams, a big right. No, that was a left. There's a big right. That just folded Kurt Adams inside out. But Adams is getting back to his feet. Adams wants to win. Chop to the throat. Another chop to the throat. Going down. Now he goes down. He just chopped. It's like just chopping down to a giant redwood. Cover. Kick out. Adams smartly going in the headlock after the pinfall. Most severe that Kurt Adams is it in the wrestling position as he goes off the rope. Close! Oh! 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 That wasn't a close one. That was a lariat. A freight train coming at you when you get hit with that. CJ's just stomping all the limbs around. Multiple points of damage coming from CJ. Big kick of some sort. As now, it is CJ who's in complete control. The world is his oyster. Adams attacks the hurt knee. Adams attacks the hurt knee. The hurt knee has been attacked.
Hey, but, hey, oh, wait a damn minute.
Oh.
Take your big ass and take it.
He's been ejected. Captain Lost to come up to the commentary desk.
Get out of here.
Double bird. Double bird. Wait. No. 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 Roll up. Roll up. Two. No.
Two.
He almost had him. He almost had him. But he didn't get him. Captain Long. Not like being ejected. Kurt Adams setting up for it. No. Splash the leg. Splash the leg. Covered. two. No, Adams kicks out again. Adams going to try to get to his feet. They're both trying to get to their feet. This will be the ending stage of this match. Things are flying. Forearm by Adams.
Stupid fucking referee.
I don't care. Shut up for a second.
No, you shut up.
Both men teeing off on one another. Both men are just going at it. They both want to be the best in the yard. That's what this is all about.
Yeah, and CJ will be the best in the yard, damn it.
We don't know that yet. We don't know that yet.
Only way Adams win this is because he got lucky.
Lady Luck might be on the Texas beard of God's side. And CJ chops his chest. That can knock the breath out of you if you're not careful. Adams is heavily favoring that chest.
Taking him to all four corners with these chops here.
He is.
Come on, CJ, lay him in. Give him one more. You only need one more. Get all four corners. Oh. There you go.
Evil needle connect four. CJ, big boot. I thought I was going to go for the K&K. Now cover.
One, two, three.
Oh, he almost had him. He almost got him. I'm running low on energy. I got a sip of the Sprite.
Yeah. What happened to your Dr. Pepper? I thought you were drinking Dr. Pepper.
I kind of snuck a Sprite into it.
Oh.
Wait.
Oh.
On the arm.
Kimura.
Kimura. Kurt Adams.
No.
No.
That wasn't a tap.
Wasn't a tap?
He tapped out.
Ref called for the bell, but management said that was not a tap out.
What?
I got that word in my ear just now.
That might need a little bit of looking back on.
Three. Four, go.
I think my brother just got screwed.
I don't know. And emotions are running so high. So high. Oh.
Oh, childbreaker.
Adams. Should be looking. The pyramid buster. Sooner rather than later, big clothesline is taking down CJ.
Trying to hit him with super that kick, super kick. Kick.
Super kick.
He almost put me away with that super kick. And down goes CJ. Adams
cover.
Floats over into
Wait.
The pin. This can't
cover.
Be it.
Oh. Adams almost had it. And you just see the desperation sitting in on Kurt Adams. He knows. There might be only one move to beat CJ. And that's that pyramid buster.
He's also got that system breaker, though.
That is true.
Yeah, that single leg code breaker.
Good to know.
Going for the bulldog.
Bulldog. Elbow drop. Pulling him into the center of the ring. Adams is going to go for a cover. No. He's going to reach the rope. I have to say that CJ has performed so well in this entire tournament. But I think he's faced with probably one of his toughest challenges in his whole career in Kurt Adams.
No! No! This is my show!
Is it?
I worked for this!
Kurt visibly frustrated.
Adams,
whoa.
I can't beat this
no.
guy.
He's making that crucial mistake.
Oh! 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 Oh!
That's it. It's gotta be.
It's
there we
over.
Go.
We have a new champion. We have a new champion.
Best
it doesn't
in the
give me
champion.
A minute. I gotta go celebrate.
Whatever. Just, we have witnessed history.
This guy right here.
Kurt Adams held that best in the yard title. Such a long time. Adam doesn't even know what he is. That
told you.
Gotta be his name.
I told you.
Interesting to me.
Yes!
As Captain Law is so happy. Flips. Gotta give Kurt Adams a little bit of props here, though. He held his own. As now
no one can deny.
It is safe to say
you are
that after tonight, after this tournament, CJ is the best in the yard.
Better than the Deltas. Better than the Blazes.
That's certainly better than the Adams, better than the Bates. Think about
being told we got to go off the air.
Forget that.
Pretty soon here, just I think we should give kind of a round of applause here. Everybody who participated in this tournament, in the Battle Royal.
Celebrate, man.
CJ, I know how much titles mean to him. This must mean the world to him. We can't see his face or know what he's feeling, but CJ, I know now he holds both of the championships and the plaque. What an image that is. What an image that is. Law has the VCW title. The very same. Once held by Nova. It's the brother's embrace. CJ's the best in the yard. Who in the hell? After FD, everybody thought he might have fell off. There's no doubt CJ is still here. That's all for this tournament, folks. Just stay tuned for tomorrow for the Night of Dreams. I'm Ben Jake Howell for Captain Law, for everybody else. Thank you for tuning in. That was for Nova. That was one hell of a tournament. Take care. Night of Dreams tomorrow. Be there.